Have you seen the new thing? The new hotness? You know, our brand new elements editor? No? I get it. You're a busy content creator. But in this video, I will walk you through our brand new editor, show you each section, and hopefully give you a great starting point into the elements editor. Let's go. We'll start on our dashboard and go over to the streaming tools section. Now click on elements. Once we're here, we can see any overlays or alerts we've worked on before on the new editor. Let's click on New Element and browse the Elements Gallery. How about this one? This one looks great, but I would like to customize a little bit. So let's jump into the editor by clicking the Customize button. And welcome to our new editor. We're going to take things slow today and explore the editor one section at a time. First, let's start with our events section on the left. This section will include all the possible events that can happen during a stream. You can click on any alert or variant of that alert, and you will see them show up on the stage area, which is the middle section of the editor. As you can see, we already have a lot of default options that you can use, but you can always add your own. For now, let's add a new variant to our subscriber alert. We want an alert to pop up specifically for Prime subscribers. Click on the three dots and choose Create New Variant. Now we select the type, which in our case will be tier. And on the tier option, we will select Prime. There, a brand new variant that will trigger an alert for all our Prime subscribers. Now let's explore the Add State button. This will include a new event type that we can then configure to trigger an alert. For example, if you have an SC merch store set up, you can add an event that triggers every time someone buys your merch. And as with any other event, you can add variants as we showed before. Basically, the events section will allow you to view, edit, and add all types of alerts and variants so that all your needs are covered. Now the static section. These two fields are for you to display static elements either in front of your alerts or behind it within the stage area. This will be very useful if you are building your own overlays. Simply click on either the foreground or the background layer, and you can then add elements via the on-screen components on the right side of the screen. Don't worry, we'll get deeper into that section soon. Now, as we mentioned before, we have the stage area. This is where you simulate and preview what will show on screen. You can preview every alert by clicking on them, and you can also simulate them using the Simulate button below. Anything that you see within the stage area is also draggable, so that means that you can easily position all the components on screen exactly as you wish. The widget size option allows you to customize the size of the stage area. You can make it limited, as we see here, or you can change it to your full resolution. Up to you. Now, let's move on to the right side of the screen. In this section, you will see all the components of your alert or overlay. If we click on our follower alert, for example, we can see that the section on the right will display all the individual components of our follower alert, such as a video and a text field. By going into these sections individually, you're able to fully customize your alert. You can not only change the visual elements, like the video showing or the text on screen, but also add components like sound or text to speech. Let's make some alterations to our follower alert. Click on the alert video component and click on Replace Assets. You can always browse the existing collection of videos and animations that you can use for free from Stream Elements or upload your own. For now, we're going to use this cool anime alert. Once you have what you want, just click on it and click Save. Position it on the screen by dragging it to where you want. Once you've locked in the position, you can also change some settings like the color properties of your video. You can change the actual color of the entire video and even the saturation. You can also refine the position with the position properties. Now let's adjust our text field. Click on the alert text box, and we're gonna drag the text just to make sure it stays exactly where we want it. And let's check some of the options. Here you can change the text font, size, the color, and much more. You can also click here to change its animation settings. Within the position properties, you can fine tune the position of the text on screen or change its alignment, as well as a nifty resizing option. Now let's select a sound to play alongside our alert. Click on the sound component and select sound. Here, similar to our video library, you have sounds provided by Stream Elements, or you can always upload your own. We're going to use our drum loop. Now let's add something extra. I would like to hear Brian read my follower alerts. Click on Add Component and select Text to Speech. I want Brian to read out the follower's name and also to thank them for following. So in the text field, let's type in slash and choose latest follower. And now let's type in our thank you message. Let's click on voice and change it to our ever loving Brian. Click save. Now that we're finished, let's simulate it.
Alex, thanks for following. You are a legend.
There we go. Perfect. And that concludes our very first tour of our new Elements editor. We hope this information was useful, and keep an eye out for more videos regarding our new editor. As always, if you want more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter, and join our Discord community at discord.gg/sc. I'll see you on the next one.